Hello, and thanks for tuning in. Growing coral and algae is one of the most discussed topics among reef aquarists. When you look online, you'll find dozens of secret formulas, special techniques, tricks and tips for getting coral and algae to grow in a reef tank. A lot of aquarists try one method after another and never achieve the results they're looking for. But here's some good news. There's no magic formula or aquatic voodoo. Growing coral and algae is quite easy, and here's what you need to know. Marine biologists refer to coral and algae as crustose coralline algae, or CCA for short. Although the algae appears purple and pink, and sometimes red, coralline algae is simply a form of red marine calcified algae. Coralline algae is quite different than most other types of algae you find in reef tanks, because the cells of coralline algae form a honeycomb structure of calcium carbonate, similar to the structure you find in stony corals, but only stronger. As the algae grows, it lays down layer upon layer of this super strong limestone honeycomb. It will strengthen wild reefs with these layers of calcium carbonate, binding together the rocks and coral skeletons, helping the reef withstand tide surges, pounding waves, and tropical monsoons. There are many species of coralline algae. Some species grow in deep, dimly lit water, while other species grow near the water surface in well-lit conditions. Some can grow in branching formations, some can be thick and planing, but for the most part, the CCA we desire is encrusting. There are many reasons people desire coralline algae to grow in a reef tank. Coralline algae is often used as an indicator organism. That means if you have CCA growth, your lighting and your water chemistry conditions are good enough for keeping stony corals. Coralline algae can tie together live rock and coral fracs, just like it does in wild reefs, helping to create a more stable aquascape inside your reef tank. This keeps your frags in place. Nuisance algae have a difficult time attaching to coralline algae. This means CCA-covered rocks rarely have any unsightly nuisance algae growing on them. Corals and other inverts prefer to attach to coralline algae-encrusted rock. Finally, the most popular reason people desire coralline algae is that it adds beautiful shades of purple, pink, and even red to otherwise drab-looking rock. There is one drawback of growing coralline algae you can't really avoid. CCA does not discriminate where it will grow. It will cover your glass, acrylic, and your rocks once it starts to grow. It will also cover your pumps and other equipment, reducing the flow rates as it infiltrates the various components of your aquarium system. Coralline algae is one of the main reasons it's important to soak and clean your pumps regularly in an acidic pump cleaner or vinegar bath. While I would not say CCA is difficult to remove, I would say it's certainly tedious and time-consuming. Coralline algae thrive in the same basic lighting and water conditions as reef-building stony corals. If your aquarium is set up and being maintained to support stony coral growth, you can grow CCA. The only other thing you need to do is seed the tank with live coralline algae to get it started. CCA reproduces by spores, one of the most efficient ways possible. The spores will settle on the rock and form new coralline algae colonies, so you only need to seed your aquarium with spores one time. CCA spores seem to be found in almost all wild reef organisms, so it's not difficult for the spores to find their way into your tank with no extra effort. All you need to do is stock the tank with the typical reef tank inhabitants. There are, however, a number of ways to intentionally introduce coralline algae, which is especially useful when a tank is being built using dry or synthetic rock, which is certainly becoming a norm over the live rock of days past. Using live rock rubble is certainly better than larger pieces of live rock because you'll run less of a risk of nasty hitchhikers getting into your system. Frags are also another terrific way to introduce live coralline algae to your tank. The CCA growing on a frag plug or a mount will work just fine. You can also add a cleaner snail or hermit crab that's encrusted with CCA. Scraping coralline from a friend's reef and adding it to your tank is yet another successful way to seed your tank. Essentially, just find something with living coralline algae on it and add it to your tank. There are a few aquarium products that are designed to seed your aquarium with CCA. At the time of this video release, the reviews of these products are mixed and we have yet to test them here at Marine Depot. If you happen to have experience with any of these products, please let us know your experience and leave a comment below. The key to success with coralline algae, the biggest secret to success, the thing that many reefers miss is patience. The ability to leave things alone is very difficult for many of us reef enthusiasts. We're always tinkering, watching our reef, and looking for coral growth, and watching for any signs of imbalance. Coralline algae often grows very slowly in a new reef. So don't be discouraged by stories and photos from a guy whose reef is a month old and yet covered with CCA. This is rare and not the norm. So just be patient. When you see coralline algae in a tank with the right conditions, coralline algae will grow. It's a simple formula, but it takes time. You will first notice little white spots start to appear on some of the surfaces inside your tank. By the time they're about a quarter inch in diameter, they will begin to take on a color and satisfy your CCA cravings. There are additives that will help coralline algae to thrive, but before you add anything, make sure your aquarium has adequate lighting, calcium, alkalinity, and water movement. Coralline algae uses calcium, strontium, magnesium, iodine, and carbonates to build their limestone structure. Products like Caripsea Purple Up, Continuum Aquatics, Coralline Purple CX, and others provide a mixture of these essential elements formulated to stimulate CCA growth with the added benefit of stimulating coral growth as well. On that note, be sure to test your tank parameters to ensure that you're not overdosing any of these elements, especially if you already have a regular dosing regimen. Likely, you'll be already maintaining the major elements of calcium, alkalinity, and magnesium, so if you notice your coralline algae growth slows or stalls, it's likely a minor or trace element deficiency. Elevated phosphates can interfere with the calcification process as well, so be sure you are maintaining a low phosphate level. To many of you, this might sound quite familiar, and is really no different than your regular reef tank water chemistry requirements. In conclusion, years of reef aquarium observations have led us to a few key factors to successful coralline algae growth. A stable environment is key for CCA growth. Be sure to seed your aquarium with some form of live CCA. When coralline algae growth stalls, additives can help jumpstart growth again. And finally, patience. Coralline algae takes time to grow and spread throughout an aquarium. I appreciate all of you for watching today, and until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.